That door thing is so weird. It freaks me out. Okay, and the hammock. Okay. Okay. I'm ready.
Let me push you in.
Oh my god, this is gonna be interesting. Thank you. Oh my
You're
god.
Welcome.
Follow my Twitter at Nikocado Avocado, and if you do, I might just follow you back.
This is amazing. Okay.
Wow. Oh.
That is so funny.
Wow.
I made you wait 30 minutes on my stoop. I felt so bad. Oh my god.
I made a video where I actually was talking about the whole situation. I got a little teary.
Wait, recently?
Yeah, like yesterday.
You have I
said I felt bad because you mentioned at your Christmas party how like the beginning of the year was really rough. Mm-hmm. And I felt, because I was sitting here in the room, I was like, oh yeah, it's my fault. You know, I was just like,
no.
I started getting really sad.
It wasn't your fault. It was a bad time anyways, and I think everything just attributed. It wasn't just you. It definitely wasn't. It just was a better time, but you know what? We're out of it. We're here.
We're so good.
I thought we were going to kiss. I was like, oh my god, are you going to kiss? You're like, I was like, ah! I'm down.
Make a video out of that.
Oh, we can't. I was going to say, we should do a drama about, well, we won't.
Okay. We're back home. Shoopy-doo, we're home. Hello, we're back home. Shoopy-doo, we're home. Hello, and this is Hot and Stevie. Because we're eating noodles.
Fettuccine rhymes with steamy better, but okay.
What?
You should have said fettuccine and says, because it rhymes with steamy.
This is hot and steamy because we're eating fettuccine.
Noodle is like weird.
New album coming out. You're good at harmonizing.
Really? I thought that one wasn't. I was like, no. Are we eating this or what?
Here we go. Okay. So, cheers. Oh. This is so. I felt like I was
this is funny.
I was carrying this over from over there, and it was leaking. I was waddly, so I went step in it. It was like leaking between
we
my legs.
We should film that. That would have been really
funny. And I felt like a dog with, you know, leaking. Okay.
I just put a bowl here because it has to catch the leaking.
Okay. Cheers.
Cheers. It's actually low-key good.
Hard to.
It's very buttery and very cheesy, and I love both of that.
Oh my god. The woman who made it. Come on out.
Mom! Here she is!
Thank you.
Mama got back. Oh my god.
They said big.
This is big.
You didn't say messy, but it's messy.
It's messy.
It's very good.
This is
my new best friend.
I know.
We were hanging out. She was my date to her party last night.
She was so excited about you. She loves you. She'll tell me. She made a video about you, and she'll like tell me updates about you. She was, did you see Nick's this? She's like, she knows. She follows you. So Mama got back.
Follow her. I'm gonna link her YouTube channel. Okay, and go give her some support, you guys.
Yeah, we'll get her a new computer so she can make videos again.
Oh.
I didn't know that was her issue that she couldn't upload. I guess she has because she does it from her MacBook. She does it from like QuickTime.
She told me QuickTime. Yeah.
Yeah. So I didn't know that was the issue.
I have an extra camera. Give her.
She just has the Mac, the QuickTime. She doesn't.
Is it easier?
I gave her a camera. I bought her a camera.
And she won't use it.
She doesn't know how to like upload it to the thing.
Oh, my mom could never. So.
Yeah. And so
the
she
fact that, the fact that she has a channel. Yeah. Is like five
oh, that was
ahead.
Sweet. Oh.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. She. Her family has been so nice to me. Her sister Callie, like.
They love you.
Wow.
My family.
I was just
you.
Talking about it in my video. I was like, I feel like.
Aww.
Like family, friends, and it's just crazy
you are.
How it happened.
Oh my.
Like, I just. I don't. Life is so funny.
That's why I always say like you shouldn't like. I don't know. I would like. I don't judge anyone because, like, of course, like originally I would judge Nick and be like, "Oh my god, drama, or whatever." But once I got to meet him, like, I was like, "Oh, we're so similar and so much alike." Which I was telling Zach, like, that's like kind of the reason I feel like maybe I didn't like you at first, or like didn't like the way you like handled the situation, because I feel like that's how I would have handled the situation. So you always like don't like reflections of you, you know? Like I see so much of me and you, and probably vice versa. But I was like, usually don't like those people.
You would have grabbed the camera too.
Yeah, like something rubs you the wrong way because that's who you are, and I don't like that about me. Like I hate that I'm so quick to like jump to the camera, but I do, and I continue to do it. And so like I think we're so similar.
Yeah. I mean, it makes great YouTube content, so you guys are here for it. I'm actually about to grab the camera pretty soon. We were just talking about that.
Oh my god, you're gonna. I won't expose your drama, but I was pissed because. I don't even know who started. I can't remember what we talked about. I was pissed because I like this person. Can I talk about this or not? Whatever. Oh. I like this person. Well, I don't know her. But I watch her and I always give her shout outs. I'm like, oh my god, I love this person so much. And then just to hear, like, their drama is their drama for sure. Like, I don't like to get, like, involved in other people's drama.
And am I out of line, or is it just flat out?
Well, here's the thing. It happens a lot in LA, but
that's
not...
That's what I said.
Not the day of.
No.
Because I'm a flaker, and I'm a ghoster.
Yes, you are.
I'm not as much anymore.
No, you're not.
No. I learned my lesson.
Actually, can I say, out of, you are super on time. Super on time.
Usually,
when you went to Zach's place, you're on time that first club, and the second one, and then like, you were on time.
Yeah, I would have been on time today, we just got lost. So, and we had to pick up the noodles and stuff like that because I was like, oh my god, we have to go get those. Because
and thank you again for getting it for me. Mm-hmm. Guys, they picked this. I was like, let's do fettuccine, and they're like, oh, we'll go. I was like, no, let me postmate it or something. But
well, the thing is, my mom cooks bomb fettuccine. We just had these huge ass noodles, and I told her let's make a big portion of it. And I think she's just not used to making this big a portion. She didn't know how much like cream is, but it's good.
It is so
good. It's really delicious. It's so funny. It's just so big. The noodles are so. Look at that cheese. Okay, cheese pull.
Whoa.
Mom, you did stretchy cheese. Zach's right. Shaking. Oh my god.
Oh.
I feel like, you know what I feel like? I feel like we're like kids having like a sleepover and my mom like cooked us dinner. Honestly.
After her Christmas party, I was one of the last people to leave, and I felt bad. I was like, should I leave? Do I invite myself out of that? Mm. But literally, we kept like talking, and everything felt good, but I almost felt like I was gonna sleep over. Like,
we're
time to go.
As I get more mattresses, I still don't have a mattress or anything. I want sleepovers all the time because like I like having people here.
Mm-hmm.
Like my mom, she slept over that night. Like I like having people sleep over. It's like so fun.
This is so good.
We're never gonna eat all this. Oh.
I will.
You gonna put more cheese on it? Mm-hmm. Do more cheese.
I know. Do we want more?
Oh my god, no.
It's so good.
It's like low key is so good.
It's
high key.
You keep saying low key.
I think I say low key out of like habit, and I don't mean it as low key. And that like low key is
we
like.
We love your cooking.
It's so good.
She's like thanks.
I feel like, there was a lot of pressure to cook this much fettuccine. And at the party, you were the last, anyway, let me finish my...
So good.
Well...
But I want to thank you again, especially on camera now that you're here with me, for inviting me to your party. Mm-hmm. That was my first LA party, and it was just so magical. Like, everyone was good energy. Even what we were talking about earlier, it was still good energy, you know?
Oh,
it was still very good energy. I mean, I had a great time. It was just very nice.
People, the group. Oh, wow. That scared the shit out of me. The low angle, mom. You just got. They know you're there. Just a compilation of my mom awkwardly in the collab. Like, 5 minutes of Lena Paytas in the Nikocado collab.
Very good energy. I mean, I had a great time. It was just very nice.
People, the group, oh.
Want some? You should try.
I'm eating out the stove.
You're eating out the stove. It's so good. Oh my goodness, here you go.
I literally feel like I'm in middle school and like my mom's like cooking us dinner. It's
us.
So funny.
Yay.
And we're just like pretending. Are you still warm? I feel bad. I tried to open up my door, but the door is
open. I was just heated. I actually feel better now.
You do? Because it's cool.
I was
in here.
Angry. Birds. When it's angry, it like ruffles its feathers and its cheeks. The feathers go out like this. It gets very stimulated, so it like, and that's when you know it's angry.
I thought your bird is gone.
It's still in Colombia.
Oh.
Yeah, it's not dead. No, one of Orland's family members. We couldn't leave him out of the. We couldn't bring him out of the country.
What happened to your sloth?
Also in Colombia as well, in a sanctuary.
Mm.
Did I ever show you my scar?
Mm-mm.
Look.
What do you do about you?
Yeah.
Is that why you got rid of him?
Yeah, traumatized me. And here's the thing, we never connected, we never had a bond, because when we got it, we literally went to Thailand a week later. And Orland's mom watched him, or her. You caught him, I caught him. I literally had no bond and no connection. I'm like, wow, this is a big waste of money. It cost $5,000, it took forever to get it.
I think it's a non-binary sloth.
Oh, like you?
I'm not binary!
I don't know.
I'm trans.
Okay, I don't know all the differences.
I don't want to be referred to as him, but...
Okay.
Anyway.
You're still like she. Let's make the record straight, because I literally said something Trisha was so nice to me. People were like, don't be mean, it's a he. I'm like, well, I don't know.
Okay, I never once said that.
I don't know.
Just because I question my gender and what I identify as doesn't mean. People are just trying to push me into, like, you're a man now, you have to identify. It's like, I was just expressing, like, my thoughts and, like, I don't know. I'm still confusing. I don't talk about it because, sorry, I just, like, ish my armpit. That was so gross. I felt judged. I was like, I'm so sorry.
I wasn't even looking at that. I'm literally just, like, pounding back the food. I'm over here like...
Mm-hmm. It looks like we didn't even put a dent in it.
It's so big.
For my collab with Nick, I was like, can we do a Trishy Land collab? Are you going to be in your underwear?
Is
that a little much?
Well, that'll make them all go over.
Oh my god, can you be in your underwear for it?
Okay, I'll be in my
underwear. I'm wearing my whole ass on. I'm wearing my thong.
I'll be in my underwear.
Mom, do you want to record it?
Yeah.
She reminds me of the Mean Girls when
she's
like,
so...
That's right, you go, sweetie.
Oh my god, no, we were all in New York with me, my mom, and sister. And there was like this shadow wall. I was like, okay, I'm gonna go hide and be naked for my Trishy Land. Like, Callie, film it, and then my mom's like watching it.
This is my dinner.
Oh, mm. How do you like it?
This is, want some on top?
No, you want some more sauce? No?
It's so good.
Hey. How do you
so,
like it?
So good.
Huh?
How do you like it?
I love it.
It's delicious.
If I could have sat a little bit, I would have gotten.
Did you Google the recipe, or is this a family passed down specialty?
Food Network, tiny woman. Mm. Thanks for
she was saying we should do a Food Network show.
We should.
Because I'm so bad at cooking, but we like to. I don't know.
You are.
I'm terrible cooking.
I thought I've seen you cook on your channel.
Yeah, that's terrible.
No, but, your dry mozzarella sticks. My mom tried to do that, and she couldn't do it.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh well. They had me audition for a Food Network star or something, and I had to
really?
Make a pizza and make it, like, with my flair. And it turned out, like, have you ever baked a pizza from scratch?
No.
Knead out the dough with the flour?
No.
Oh, man, it was hell. It was terrible. We probably went through four pizzas.
Before. Really?
Here's the one.
What happened to it? Did you ever hear back? Sorry, I'm missing.
They didn't like me. That's okay.
Why?
Because I can't cook.
Well, you should be on, like, Worst Cooks, like the one
that's helping. Yeah, that's my speed, Worst Cooks.
I would
cook.
Be on that one, too.
Yeah.
Because I can't cook. Where did I do? Oh, there's a video of me cooking eggs, and I'm, like, cooking eggs for, like, 20 minutes, and, like, I just never had the burner on. And I'm like, why are these eggs cooking? And I wasn't trying to be funny in the video either. I was like, wait, because it was just a vlog. It wasn't even, like, a cooking video.
That is so me.
Yeah, I was like, why are these cooking?
That is so me. So me. Actually, when I first started mukbang, some of my older videos, I used to have this tray. I would put oil on to cook something, and it would pop everywhere and go on my face. Like, it would just be popping everywhere.
Nick, Tosh talked about that, didn't he? I always bring up Tosh with you.
Huh? You love that I was on Tosh.
I know.
Every time. Actually, at our Christmas party, she announced everyone, like, this is Jeffree Star. He is an entrepreneur. This is Shane Dawson. This is Nikocado. He's been on Tosh. And I'm like,
I love Tosh.
I don't even... Think of it like
I love that. I'm so jealous that you got that. I want to be a web star.
Well, I want to be on Celebrity Big Brother so we can trade.
Oh my god, they canceled that show.
Really?
Yeah, it's awful. Don't worry, it was awful. It was the worst show ever.
Oh, I was rooting for you.
Really?
So many people were.
Really?
And remember, and well, I don't. Well, I know from my perspective, you left and you had all of this like.
Mm-hmm.
All your haters all of a sudden became supporters.
I didn't know that.
It happens to me all the time. Like, I feel like no one likes me. Oh my gosh. And then you leave. And it's like everyone was like cheering for
me.
Not entertained by you, so.
I honestly thought everyone hated me. Because, like, the night I left, I was in the bottom four. And then I was in the bottom two. But I think they fucked that. I think they rigged it. Because they said I was in the bottom two. But I was like, I don't think I was. I think they just said that to, like, piss me off. You know what I mean?
It's off stage.
Mm-hmm. That's like, what I think. What happened?
I leaked.
Oh, I ate.
I think like on American Idol, they already know who the person is, but it's just.
Oh yeah, totally. It's 100% rigged.
Hydrogen water. Ooh. Athletic performance
infused.
Reduced inflammation from exercise. Deliver powerful antioxidants. Ooh. Drink best consumed within 30 minutes after opening. That's water. Does it expire? What? Hydrogen. Hydrogen molecules. Okay.
I'm gonna make your face glow. You have really good skin, actually. For eating as much cheese and stuff that you do, because mine breaks out from
cheese.
It's
the water.
Oh, really?
It's the water. It's the water weight, literally. I sell t-shirts today, it's just water weight.
Really?
I joke, I'm like, oh, no, it's not that. It's just water.
Mm.
But I drink almost a gallon every day.
Really?
And I never drink anything else. And it helps thin your blood naturally. It helps digestion. It helps your colon.
Your skin's great.
Helps your kidneys with detoxing, like, sodiums. It literally helps with everything. So I just drink water.
Honestly, that must be it because, like, you eat a lot of cheese and stuff. And, like,
I eat shit. My whole channel, like, you look at my channel, you're like, how is this man, like, so alive? You know?
Yeah.
The thumbnails are grotesque, but.
No, they're good.
It's water.
My New Year's resolution, I'm, like, not eating cheese for all of January. I gotta, like, no cheese January. I've been eating so much. Yesterday with Zach, we had three of those Korean fried cheese each, and then we dipped it in cheese.
Oh, yeah, he eats bad, too. He's just like me.
How is he so skinny? He lost weight. I'm like, how do you lose weight?
Right?
I don't understand.
I lost 1 pound as a mukbanger.
That's good. Honestly, that's something. So it really is.
I know everyone's shading me for that, but.
No, I say that's better. What? You could be.
Oh, no, I'm not saying you're shading me. I'm saying.
No, I know, but I'm saying why would people do that? It's better than gaining weight. Like, losing a pound is losing a pound.
I say, like, I did it while filming 40 videos a month. Like, that's amazing.
Mm-hmm,
like, I pat myself on the back. Mm. 1 pound. And it's not even the weight thing, because I don't even care about the number on the scale. You know, 250, 280, 270, I don't care. It's more so like how I feel.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there are some days where I was just like, oh my god, I can't move.
Yeah.
And you can feel the salt in your fingers, and you're like, oh. I just felt so much better.
Well,
so
it's like a balance thing. I think you'll get it. I mean, it's hard. I mean, I used to do mukbangs all the time, and like, I was feeling the same way. It's just how I felt. I was just like, I don't care how I look. It was just like how I felt.
We don't do mukbangs as much anymore.
I try not to. I mean, I just, like I said, I only because, like, it's how I feel. You know, I'm the same way. I'm like, oh, I don't like to feel, especially because I can't exercise because of my knee right now. But maybe once I get back into dancing.
Is it still giving you issues?
Yeah, it just gives out.
6 months later?
Well, you know what it is? It's like, it's fine. And then, like, one day I'll literally just be, like, lifting myself into my car and it just gives out.
Really?
So it scares me.
So you fall or you get weak?
It just buckles.
Mm.
And then I get scared because I'm like, oh my god, did it like pop out or something? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because it hurt. That was the most pain I've ever been in.
That's
so.
Right.
Mm-mm, this one. And like, that's the thing. I can bend it. But it's just like when I put weight, like if I were to like lean over and like have it bent, it would hurt.
Oh.
It's whatever.
And people are saying you did it for publicity too.
I don't know what that.
Like, I don't feel like someone would like hurt themselves like that for publicity.
Yeah, and I would have done a better injury. I would have used crutches more often. I also did it in the middle of tour, so I couldn't dance, and I was so miserable because I love dancing. Like, dancing's the only thing that makes me happy, so I've been able to dance. It's been sucky.
In the middle of tour too.
Mm-hmm.
In the middle of tour, that would make me cry.
Well, I loved it.
Cry.
Yeah.
Like, I loved it.
Yeah, I loved tour.
Yeah.
But and if I did that to try and cancel tour, I would have canceled it, but I still hobbled along to those shows in pain. I was in so much pain that first weekend. I was like, oh my god.
Aww.
Mm-hmm.
Are you gonna need surgery or anything, do you think?
I mean, we probably should, but I'm like really scared of that.
Mm-hmm. So. You just went to the doctor. Oh, that was for something else.
Plastic surgery.
Different type of surgery.
I mean, I vlogged it, so yeah, I hopefully get some plastic surgery, but.
Ooh, are you nervous for that? I told her, like, the only thing I would ever consider is pulling this back like this. See?
You need to document it if you did. I don't think you need it.
Oh,
I don't.
Yes, I look like a turtle, but like this.
Turtles
like,
are cute.
Say that's so much better.
Yeah, but I think all that everybody. Mine too.
I don't even care, the belly, the thighs, I don't care. It's just right here. That's my biggest insecurity.
Really?
That's what I talk about all the time. I'm like, hi.
Aww, that makes me sad. Like, self-deprecation makes me sad because I do it too. But when people do that, I'm like, oh, that makes me sad because I know that you're insecure about it. Because I'm the same way. I like self-deprecate because I embarrass myself. But you shouldn't do that.
What do you self-deprecate about?
I mean, everything. Literally being fat, being dramatic, being emotional, and never keeping a guy. Like, just stuff I'm, like, insecure about. I just, you know. What? It's just so warm.
You don't tell him about the new guy, right? You don't know.
Oh.
That's your own little thing.
No. It's not that I don't talk about it. I think I've talked about it on, like, Patreon. I'm sorry. I'm, like, going in on this.
It is so good.
You know what it is? It's just I don't see a future with it, so I don't talk about it. And I'm not, like, giddy over it. I feel like if I'm giddy over someone, I talk about it. But it's kind of just a thing. I mean, I don't care about talking about it. I'm like, whatever. But
you're going to find someone. Everyone deserves someone. Yeah. It doesn't matter who you are, what you look like. Everyone deserves someone, you know.
I guess maybe it's Zach Choi.
Oh.
Kidding, I think he has a girlfriend. I don't know. I'm not giving any information. I mean, he might not.
He's literally about to come over in like 5 minutes. He's just over here like, I hope I'm married to him happily ever after. It's like, oh.
Why do I low-key like love him? And I get nervous.
Everyone loves him. You get nervous around him?
Kind of. Like, yeah. We were by ourselves yesterday, and then like, you know, after a collab, like, you never know if you should like just leave, but then you feel like, I don't want to think I'm just leaving and just using him for views. Like, okay, bye.
Yeah.
But I also want to stay around, but I'm like, maybe he doesn't want me to stay around.
I'm the type of person you have to tell me. I'll sit here and chat all day.
Yeah.
Good night. I'm like, oh, okay, bye. You know.
Yeah, you guys stay till the end, which I love. I love that too.
Yeah, I was thinking, like, should we have been kicked out? I don't know.
No, not at all.
Because it was very personal. It was Shane, Rylan, me. There's literally four people.
Morgan,
and that's it.
I love that little group.
I know they're. You guys have a lot of history, and we don't. I didn't know if I was like.
No, they're not like that. You know, that's what I love so much about them. They, like, it include everyone and anyone, like, they're really, really cool like that. Like, I love
felt
that.
Very inclusive with everybody.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah.
No one was, like, standoffish, like,
no.
Why, like, who are you, kind of thing. Like, even people didn't know. Like, I was talking to Morgan, and it was as if we'd known each other for years. She's so comfortable, you know?
Morgan, oh my god, Morgan and Rylan, I mean, Shane too, but, like, Morgan and Rylan are just, like, those people that, like, make everyone, like, I went over 4th of July when it was just their family, it was just all the Adams there, and, like,
I literally thought it was just, like, a neighbor, like,
yeah, they're so sweet.
Obviously, I know her, but I mean, like, the way they come across us, so it's just a friendly neighbor. It wasn't just like, I'm a YouTuber.
Oh yeah, they're not.
I have, yeah, like, I didn't sense
they're
any
so
of
cool
that.
And what the cool thing about Nick too is, like, when he hangs out at parties, like, he's very
Nick
humble.
Oh, you. Me. Oh.
Nikocado.
I'm thinking of Nick.
Why did my mom say your name that night? Remember, she went, oh, what'd she say,
like,
upstairs?
Nikocado.
Yeah, remember upstairs, and you're like, you took my jacket, and she goes, no I didn't.
Oh yeah.
Do you remember that, mom?
What?
Okay.
Your mom
she's
was
like,
gone.
She's like, he's like, do you know where my jacket went? I was like, your
remember
jacket.
Remember I gave you my jacket and you couldn't find it?
No.
Yeah, you're on the top of the stairs. Like, no, I didn't.
You're like, I gave you my jacket.
I went to that. I was like,
Yeah, you passed out. You're the first one to pass out. She was the first one to pass out.
My mom, he's like, no, I gave, and she's standing. He's like, no, I gave him. She goes, do you know where his jacket is? I'm like, no, but is it in the glam room? That's where everyone is wearing their jackets. And he's like, I gave you my jacket. My mom's like, no, you didn't. And he's like, I did. He goes, I'm not mad. I just, you know, did you ever prime it? Where was it?
In the glam room.
I said that. I was like, well, everyone's putting jackets in the glam room, so that would make sense. No, but what I was going to say before that was that he's, like, you're super, like, humble is a good word, but also, like, I would say kind of even, like, maybe reserved. Like, you would think, like, as a YouTuber, you want to be center of attention, but, like, you're not like that at all. You're very, like, hang to the back. Like, you're very, like, low-key. You talk to everyone. You're really social because, like, you said you were scared to become alone. You came with Zach, technically, but,
yeah,
and so that's why, but you're really social, but you don't need to be, like, center of attention, which is like those kind of people that I like, that like if it just flows naturally and stuff like that, like I like that.
Do you like me? Like, I know on YouTube we love the attention.
The attention, yeah.
But like
no.
In real life, you don't strike me as someone who like wants all eyes on you. Like,
oh no.
You like performing, but when the performance is over, you don't want.
It's why I'm like ugly in my vlogs.
And that's
when
why we're
go
very
public.
Similar too, because people, they're probably hearing this saying that sounds definitely not like Nick.
Oh no, but no, because like in real life you're like more, I don't want, I'm like that. That's why I go up with like trashy hair, no makeup when I go on public, because I don't like people like looking at me.
Yeah,
like it's
me
weird
too.
Unless I want the attention, and then I want it, and then I'll be big Trish or whatever.
Yes.
But and obviously at my party I'm like center of attention because obviously it's my party. But
even
like,
so I remember seeing the way you were standing and just kind of like everyone's happy for you. You're just like, I could tell that you just want to chill. And
if I go to someone else's party, I'm definitely wallflower. I'm definitely like, people think I'm almost stuffed up to the point because I'm so shy. Not even shy, I'm just like very like, oh, I don't want people to think like because I'm a YouTuber that I need attention or anything, you know.
Yeah. Or everyone needs to praise you or something.
Yeah, I hate that.
Fan.
Yeah, where was I? And it was something like that too, and I was just like, oh no, I don't really need, I forgot, but I truly don't need to be center attention. I feel like people think that. I also feel like we both are similar in the fact that we think people have like preconceived like notions about us. Like I assume people for my OnlyFans. I mean, my last boyfriend's ex-wife literally just never wanted to meet me or have me around her kids because she saw what she saw online. And so like that's a lot of people. So I just assume people think I'm trashy.
Yeah.
People think I'm dramatic. My channel.
Yeah.
Anyways.
We get. I love you, Trisha. We're gonna be on her. I'm doing. Well, I didn't even know, but last minute she's like, we should do an ASMR. We're eating something.
Hey.
Check out her ASMR channel, you guys. I'm gonna link that down below as well. Is it monetized yet? Oh, good. Good. I didn't know if you were monetized yet.
I have 7,000 subscribers.
Okay, let's get her to 70.
And I love it so much. It's my favorite channel.
Aw, because you don't have to talk.
Mm-mm.
No Talkie Trishy. Is that what it's called?
Mm-hmm. No Talkie Trishy ASMR.
No Talkie Trishy ASMR.
That's a long title.
Well, I might Nikocado Avocado. I literally hate my name, but...
I like it. And then also, my podcast you're going to be on after this. We have so much to do. Podcast, Trishy Land, ASMR.
It's working. And then, are you doing a mukbang or is it the ASMR of the mukbang?
ASMR. I don't think we'd eat again.
No. Well, I could.
I'm
fat, but... No, it's so funny. I was just thinking of the name thing. I remember Freely told me, she's like, Nick, you're not going to go far if you don't change that name. She's like, it's really hard to say, remember.
Where's Freely now? Does she make videos still? Like, not even shading her. Does she make videos?
She's made like 5 about us. That's funny.
You never hear about her. Like, I'm not saying that to be shady at all. But people used to talk about her. Like, Jenna Marbles used to talk about,
about her. People are over it. It's the same old thing. Like, you're not vegan, so I don't like you.
I am.
Unless you're vegan,
so
I don't
annoying.
Like you. She literally, we had like a little friendship going and she threw me under the bus, like totally. She wrote me this nasty email saying like, how could I be friends with someone like you? Look at you. Look at yourself. I should read it on camera.
Ew, really?
So,
you still have it?
So mean. Yeah, I could pull it up on my phone. Like, look at you. Look at yourself in the mirror. Are you happy with how you look? How could I be friends? And she's so like, oh, don't fat shame, you know, da da da. It's like, she just. Now, had I been a vegan with the way I look, she'd been like, oh, good. You're doing the good thing. Like, you know, like.
Yeah, because vegans can be heavy.
Oh, God, it's just...
I mean, here's the thing.
People like that you can't rationalize with. It's almost like when people interpret religion for, like, bad things and you just can't... You're like, and there's no logic there. It's just like, this says this. It's like, okay, well, that same text also says another thing, but you're doing that, so why are you picking that, you know? I get it all the time for the gay thing, like, oh, well, the God says don't do this. It's like, well, there was fucking slaves back in that... time period too, like now you have to evolve. It's just
that's the craziest. Like when Christians say that, I'm like, you are so insane if you think God like created people to like be evil. Like, you know what I mean? Like, oh, what? Like, that makes no sense about Christians. When you like know God created this person, like, how would you say like God doesn't like you. God created you. Of course he loves you. Like, he loves everybody. Like, I truly believe he even loves murderers. I think they just have something, like, wired, like, wrong. Like, something happens to them or something, but...
The wires go off.
Yeah, but I... The Pope forgot he got shot and then, like, forgave that person, like, right away. You know what I mean? I think, like, they're, like... everyone's a human. Some are just, like, off. Gay people are not off. Like, what the... I mean,
the Catholic vlogger. That was one of your first channels.
Oh my god, okay, yes. How do you know about that?
Because it's still pinned on your profile.
Is it?
Like, if you go to Trisha Paytas, on the side it says Catholic vlogger.
Really?
It's like recommended channels.
Oh my god, so funny. Yeah, yeah. I mean, even my Christian music, I love God, I love Jesus, I am Catholic, but like...
Jesus.
Oh, hey, that's the violin.
Jesus.
You give me reason, you give me hope. Jesus never let me go. Wow, we should go on tour with that. I'm a Catholic, but like obviously I have premarital sex. Obviously I love like gay people are people. I don't believe like everything the Catholic Church stands for. Abortions, have it if you need it, if you want it, if it's not right for you.
Every time I try talking about politics, I always be like, Nick, they don't want to hear it. So
I definitely don't want to hear
politics. I don't even know how that came up. I was talking about
fish. Oh, no, I don't care. Oh my god.
I started talking about Catholic. I'm sorry, I probably...
Oh, I don't care. Wait, why did you ask that though? Oh, just because? Like,
Oh, because she said my name. I had to change my name because you said Trishy ASMR. Trishy, no talkie.
No talkie, Trish ASMR.
Like, it's too long of a name.
But my vanity URL is trishasmr.com.
Oh, that's easy.
So I'm going to get a billboard. I'm so extra. I'm going to get a billboard and it's like me, like, with just tape over my mouth and I'm naked and it's going to say trishasmr.com.
Ooh.
Yeah, and I'm going to advertise it all over LA, which I don't know why because no one gives a fuck about ASMR, but like, I love watching ASMR people.
Ooh.
So
how much does it cost? Well, we can talk about that on camera.
It's nothing, no.
Because I know you've been on a billboard.
Yeah, it's like 5 to 8,000 depending on where you are. I mean, you can get
some for a month.
Mm-hmm. I mean, there's some, like, if you want Hollywood and Highland, like,
honestly imagined way more than that.
40,000. Sometimes it's 40,000. Like, if you want a prime location on Hollywood and Highland, 40,000. But yeah, I had one in Hollywood and it was like $5,000. There's one, the ones in this area, they're like 8,000.
Oh, yeah, that's nice. Mm-hmm. That's pretty good.
Yeah, so, yeah. I mean, oh my god, I just got like cheese curdles in my stomach. I'm literally just like, oh. I mean, I'm fine. We're good.
We're about to go do a podcast and we're gonna be like, hi.
This is the time to do a podcast. My guy's almost here and stuff like that, and we're going to get kids. Oh, and with Trishy Land, my mom will film it, so she will do. I'll be like, hey.
If you guys watch it, I haven't played for like 2 years.
That's what you're worried about? You're going to be in your underwear next to me with my ass and
I do not care about my underwear. I care more about if I sound good.
I'm excited.
People are going to judge me because I actually can. I used to play really, really well. It's just been for, it's been so long. But I'll make it sound good. I'll try.
Oh, we're getting copyright because we're too off pitch.
Right?
I'm never copyrighted when I sing because I'm so off key that they like the copyright system doesn't doesn't notice it. They're like, oh,
that's okay. Good. Yeah. No, sometimes I stop myself too. I start singing a song. So anyway,
I love that.
Anyway, well, let's say goodbye.
Oh, are you done too?
I'm done. I don't even know what to talk about. I'm just chilling.
Me too.
I feel cheesed out.
I'm so cheesed out.
Yeah, it was very, very good. We love Mama Got Back. Why'd she, speaking of names, why is that her name? Because she got your back?
Mama Got Back. Mom, why is it Mama Got Back?
I don't know, you said it was good, but
Shay,
more cheese?
Oh my god.
Look how many they saw. Yes, we did. It was a mountain.
Do you want to film this for your channel, The Leftovers? You can just go ahead and sit
down
and
then
film.
You guys leave and Kelly would come up and see.
I know, my sister does that. So when I'm done with mukbangs, my sister didn't know the cameras were still on, but she would come and like just start eating it. And I would ask her beforehand, I'm like, do you want some of this? Like before I start eating, like seafood boils.
And would you put that in your...
Oh, at the end, I started doing it because I was like, oh my god, she's doing this every time I'm done eating. And she's like my assistant too, so she like cleans up and then I just see her on the camera.
Orland does that for me sometimes.
Clean up? Yeah.
Well, yeah, because I leave a lot of food and he'll come in and...
I'll eat? Yeah.
Yeah, like, how dare you're starving your husband, did it?
No.
Poor Orland deserves his own fresh meal, you know, slave driver, didn't
No, because I even asked my sister, like, oh, do you want me to order you some food?
Sometimes they don't want to say yes.
Oh,
and
yeah.
They're actually happy finishing yours.
And with my sister, she, even to my mom, they live together or something, and she'll, like, even tell my mom, like, my mom's like, do you want a sandwich? Okay. Yeah. And she'll be like, oh, do you want a sandwich? I'm like, Arby's, and my sister will be like, no, but my mom will get two anyways, and then my sister eats it later. Mm-hmm. So sometimes they, like, don't think they want it until they see the food, and they're like, oh, yeah, this time looks good.
Exactly.
So.
That's so cute, picking it up at the end. Oh,
It was so cute, and I told her she should have her own channel and call it, like, Callie's Leftovers, because she literally just eats all my leftovers.
Callie's Leftovers.
Because mm-hmm. She has a channel, too, but she's not posts, but.
It's been a couple years since she's posted on there.
Yeah. I know, she should be on it. She's good, but...
I literally, at the party, I told her that. I'm like, why don't you ever just record in the background, just something? And she's like, no, I'm better off camera.
Which is so weird, because she's not...
She likes being behind the scenes.
Yeah. Well, Orlin, I feel like, is, like, the same way. He kind of is, like, fine on camera, but doesn't necessarily
He's
love
fine
it.
On camera, but doesn't... That's...
Because that's my sister.
Exactly. Doesn't necessarily... Mm-hmm. Like, literally, I just posted on his channel today, because he hasn't posted for 2 weeks. I'm baby, the algorithm. So I just put, I filmed a mukbang and posted it there.
Oh, cute.
Yeah. I want him to get a plaque that says Orlin Home.
Oh, cute. Yeah, I love that. Oh my God, I love it. All right. Should we stretch our bellies out before the podcast?
Yeah. What are we going to talk about?
We're going to get into
it. Do you have questions for me?
Yeah.
I watched your, oh, okay. Ooh.
Well, you.
I don't know. This is not Hillary Clinton. Get all the questions beforehand. Okay.
I know.
No scandal. I have no idea what you're
You want to know what it is? Actually, I don't really have questions beforehand. I just really love like talking to people and like getting to know people on my podcast. So I don't really like to, I like to know what they're doing. Obviously I know about you. So I have like already everything in my head, but like with Jeffrey and Shane, I just winged it and I just like winging it and like seeing where the conversation goes. So
okay.
Good.
Okay. So that means I have to think too. Like,
think. Okay. I don't think that hard. But.
Like, okay, let me think of something to say. I don't know.
Yeah. No, this is my first casual.
This is my first podcast.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so excited.
My first one.
Check it out. TrishPodcast.com.
That's right. So you have lots of things to do. You have to go to her channel. Link down below. Mama Got Back, link down below, and go thank her for making this.
This
for
is really
us.
Good.
It was really sweet of her, honestly. Like, she didn't have to do this, and she did. And also, I'll link the podcast. So if you want to see me over there,
and ASMR,
and see, okay, oh, and the ASMR,
and so what? I don't even know how she does it. Okay,
I don't know.
This one's cute. Oh man, this is so hard. This is actually so cheesy now. It, like, doesn't move.
We chopped it all up.
I know.
It doesn't move.
Like, you can't even do it on this spoon.
Okay. I can't.
I don't know how, like, they do it. The Hunger Diaries does that too. Do you watch her?
Who's that?
I don't know.
Maybe
she
if
does,
I saw her.
She does, like, yeah, I think you would know. Okay, I can't even eat
I can't bite. Even.
Little spoon stand for you. You're with Nikocado.
You're right too. Well, how many years older are you?
31. How old are you? I don't even
27.
Know.
27.
Oh, you're young.
Okay, so when you were 27, you would.
Oh, well, I did, yeah.
That's
even 31, but...
We're very similar, but she's starting to mature faster than me because she's older.
It is aging.
I'm noticing it's like less and less like, duh, like as you get older. So I'm just like, well, I'm young, so I still have my opportunity to be.
Oh, shade.
Huh?
Shade.
What?
Shade. Like, I'm young.
No, I just, you know, no.
I'm kidding. I'm so kidding.
No. I'm not even new.
I'm kidding. I literally call myself old. No, I mean, self-deprecating right there.
No. The whole age thing's, I don't care about age at all.
No, and I don't even, and I hate when older people be like, with age, but it's like, it is true. Like, I feel like, even.
You've had lots of practice.
You know what it is?
Dealing with people, dealing with conflict, running a channel. You just have, the more practice, it just.
It's fun. Like, exposing people is, like, fun, and, like, it feels like, not even fun, I want to say fun. It feels good to, like.
With that popcorn.
It feels good to, like.
It
when
feels
people
for me
are
to
fake,
get it off the chest, and
I don't like fake people either. So we're similar to that. I hate when people are so fake off camera and people see them one way, and it does, like, there is some sort of like validation to bring that to light, so people are seeing it, and maybe like with me, maybe it does like kind of help them in a way. Like, even with me, it kind of helped me in a way because.
Oh my God, no, totally.
Do you know what I mean? So in a way,
you
see
respond
it helping.
To everyone now,
right?
And for me, like, even with her, like, I said three things, she ignored, and I stopped. I'm like, the more I say it, the more I look crazy too. You know how it's just like, hi,
right.
How are you? You know, that's something I still take away to this day where I'm like, Nick,
right.
Don't get too excited. You're excited, but
right.
Clearly they're ignoring you, so you just have to, like, let it go.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something it's true. Yeah.
Drama. There's so many things that come up. Even, like, this hot tea situation, which is, like, not drama in my opinion. I did address it today, which I normally wouldn't, but because so many people didn't really understand
it. My DMs, see, my DMs were a lot of people because I made a whole video about someone who had flagged down the channel and stuff. But I haven't seen the videos, and she was telling me they were literally taking it and re-uploading. They didn't sit there and be like, so this is what I think, that they didn't even show her face, right? She wasn't even in it.
No, which is
so
weird because she
different.
Was pretty and she edits good and stuff, and I'm like, why don't you just do this kind of, why don't you just be a commentary drama channel? Like, that's what her last two videos were, with her on the bed and her face, like, talking about the situation and me exposing me, which is fine, whatever, if you want to do that. But even during, like, our thing, people were using my videos, like, people, I'm saying I ghosted them, and, like, it's like, I don't, because to be honest, I don't notice those things, but because she made this video, like, all this attention, obviously I looked at her channel, and then I realized, oh my God, like, her videos, like, she's using this whole thing. So, like, if someone brings attention to it, and here's the thing, even in, I've asked you so many times with Veronica Wayne thing, I still don't quite understand that.
It's
but, just, like, copyright, some people who do that to your videos, like, cut them down. Like, I still think, like, if you feel like your work is being stolen, like, flag it. You know, I don't know. Like, I don't think people should know that. It should be like, she goes, we could just ask me. I'm like, okay, no, but like, you know this. This is why there's rules on YouTube. Like, don't copyright shit. Like, you know what I mean? And stealing like a whole video, like that was like, especially the podcast. Anything else I don't care about. I make no money off it now, but I spent so much money on the living room, the, you know, paint.
I didn't know people are coming to record us. I
think yeah. Oh, yeah. There. No, that's what I'm saying. I pay a videographer. He edits it. He does the clips for me. He gives me trailers. Like,
I didn't even know.
Podcast One, they do editors for the podcast. Like, it's a big thing. And it's like, we're trying to make money off of it. And we're trying, because people think I'm like bawling. But no, I hustle. That's why I do OnlyFans. That's why I do a Patreon. Because I have to hustle and make money. So I work fucking hard. So
she, that's, shit. Okay, that's something I really respect about you.
Yeah, even in general. Like, I mean, I always reinvest my own money, which is why I hate when people steal my shit. Especially the podcast, because I reinvested so much money into like making this like studio and like all this stuff to make it cool. And even getting like Jeffrey and Shane, they don't do interviews a lot, so getting that is exclusive on my own. So for someone else to steal that interview is bullshit, because I never asked them for favors. They did it as because friends, and like I would never ask them to do it again. And so it's like, you know, I mean, I would love to have them back, but you know what I mean, like I just, I'm not that person. So like for them to like steal those interviews, it was like I was pissed. So I was like, I worked so hard for those friendships and like building that relationship with them to trust me. It's like, fuck that shit. So anyway, I don't care. Like, for, it doesn't bother me, but I just don't like when people are like, wow, how could you do that? You're so like sneaky. If I wanted to be sneaky or petty, like I could have just claimed, because you can claim it and take the money. I know like Onision does that. Like, he'll like claim people's videos and take the money.
So he's definitely gone off the deep end. Wow.
That's a whole other show I don't want to think about. I mean, I hear,
disturbing.
But
I followed his Twitter just to see what was going on, and it was just like, ooh.
I just stay away from, like I said, the older you get, you just try and stay away. From certain things, and I like to be in my own bubble, and very few people get in my bubble, but,
I'm gonna have one more bite.
Yeah, have it. Take it. I'm like,
I'll take it the whole
time. I'm in such a cheese. I'm in a cheese.
I haven't eaten all day.
I know, and you know what? I was
snacking before protein. This. I need, like, chicken. If you had breakfast.
Yeah, we can get chicken.
You had breakfast, too. I had breakfast. She doesn't sleep.
Oh, you're right. How did she know? Oh, after I was like, how did she know that?
Your Instagram.
Yeah, because I get up early. Yeah, you're right. I did have breakfast. Well, and I was eating cookies and chips before this, so.
Oh,
I was
the makeup artist.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He kind of looks a little, well, not, okay, maybe not that simple, but a little bit reminds me of my husband. He's Latino, dark skin, short hair, brown eyes.
Oh, I can see that. Yeah, oh, he's Colombian.
Is he?
Yeah, that's so weird. Cause really? Like, where's he from? He's Colombian. Let me see.
Okay, just to make sure they're right here. Really?
Yeah, he's Colombian. We were just talking about this morning because he, his family goes down to Colombia for plastic surgery and stuff. He's 100% Colombian.
Wow. Yeah. Oh, see, I sensed.
Oh, that's so weird. That's so funny. Yeah, that is like him.
Orland, he showed me one of his cousins who I never met.
Uh-huh.
He looks so identical to him.
Really?
Yeah, and I was just like, ooh, backup plan. He's gay too.
Love that.
Yeah, but he literally looks just like
one him. One of my exes hit on Nikocado. There's just so many.
Oh.
That was juicy. There's so many strawberry you gave me today.
I mean.
This is what I'm saying with age. The only maybe would have been bothered by a lot of this stuff. Something you think pissed me off a little bit, because I was like, who the fuck are you? I didn't even ask you on your channel, but...
She's just... Oh, there's my dick. Sorry, I'm trying to find...
Can I post on OnlyFans?
Was he
my OnlyFans to see his.
No. Where's the fucking photo? I think it's back here. So, oh, here we go.
Oh my god, that literally looks like him.
Looks just like him.
Okay. Okay, his birds.
Kid, yeah, we love birds. I want to meet your sister's bird. I know.
No. That bird's so annoying.
I actually was watching one of your sister's old videos the other day, because again, the whole like come to the party, I'm like, oh, I want to make sure I know people who's there, just catch up.
Right.
And I was like, oh, she hasn't made videos for like 5 years, but I still watched one of them, and I kept hearing this noise because the bird wasn't on screen, and it was like behind the camera. I just heard,
oh, did you watch my mom's videos? It's fucking loud.
And I was like, what is that? And I go through the comments to see if anyone's commenting about like what that noise is, and then all of a sudden it's like bird noise, and she's like, oh, what's his name?
Pixie,
yeah, she addressed it by name. I was like, Pixie, stop, no. I'm like, oh, it's the bird. I was like, what was that?
That bird is so annoying. Even if my mom's moving, it's a lot. It's like, bow, bow. I'm like, oh, God. That bird, you can go watch it. My mom has it in the she has one where she's like holding the dog and the birds on her shoulder. I was just like, okay.
No birds for you?
No.
They do have quiet ones, but.
No birds. I'm not a bird person. No, thank you. I love cats. I love Zach's cat, Loki. I want to keep him.
Yeah.
He was just chilling like this on the couch the other day, and I was like,
legs open and everything.
Yeah,
he's a very sexual cat.
He is.
He comes up and does all this stuff.
I know, I love him.
Yeah, it's because he still has his balls. He's about to get. Did he get them removed from anyone?
Yeah, he said it today on his Instagram
story. Oh, yeah.
Poor Loki.
Yeah. Well, anyways, you guys, check out her channel. Check out all our other collabs.
We have like lots of collabs.
Podcast, ASMR, everything.
So. Trishyland.
Trishyland.
OnlyFans.
That's she so really. Much. She really wants you there.
I told you I hustle. I'm not a rich bitch like people think I am.
You have to work for it. Yeah,
gotta work.
Mm-hmm. You do. She works very hard.
Thanks.
That's what I love about you, Trisha.
Thanks, Nikocado.
Thank you for inviting me back, and thank you again for making this.
Oh my god, that's my mom, but yeah.
Well, you did too.
Oh, thanks. With love, in my mind.
You made it happen.
Aw, I love that.
Bye, guys.
Bye.